Alright, George, we need to find the girl. That's a washing machine?
The machine was broken.
Clearly.
That vine rope could be useful.
Everything in this game is useful.
A crude wooden wheel with wooden slats.
Oh wow, 11. Jesus. Should that Redex girl Quaramante City, what place? Capital cities go. Sure took some beating. At the bottom end of the scale. But the trail is hot. We found Ubier cozying up to a guy in charge. Some sleazeball called General Graciento. I tried to talk to them, but I got zilch. Bumped into my old friends Pearl and Dwayne. Oh, he said Pearl and Dean then. Who I first met in Syria. Dwayne is as nutty as the proverbial fruitcake. He claimed to work for the CIA. Jury's still out on that one. He seemed pretty keen to bust Miguel, a local musician, out of jail. No idea why. Nico and I met the manager of a local mining company, Conchita, who claims that her mine was sabotaged. We agreed to help her as part of an exchange. Nico took the general off to interview him while I sneaked a peek at his map. It can't be a coincidence that Ubia's architectural expedition is right where the sabotage mine is located. Maybe Ubia has been trying to scare people away from the area around the mine. I wonder why. Then, just as I thought I was ahead, Ronaldo, El General's assistant, locked me in one of the cells. So now I need busting out of jail too. Dwayne sprung me and Miguel from jail. Not the most elegant of rescues, but do I care? Nico arrived just in time and we hightailed it out of there and escaped on an old fishing boat. We headed upriver towards the mine. The archaeological expedition and inevitably trouble. Just when we thought we were safe and had settled down for a well-earned kip, a helicopter appeared from the darkness and bombed the boat. I remember being blown into the water and debris falling all around me. Then the stream carried me away. I looked around for Nico, but I couldn't see her. Did she make it? God, I hope so. Chiberidon?
Perfect for a game of poo sticks.
That's not where I thought that was gonna go.
A wooden box was connected to the nearby water wheel. The water wheel had been built to provide a natural source of power. The wheel had a rim of roughly beaten iron.
So it's old. Or hastily constructed. Why are they rustling?
It was a pile of damp leaves. It was a pile of damp leaves.
But they're rustling.
It was a pile of damp leaves.
All right, George, I get it.
It was a large wooden cross.
Don't take it. That's someone's grave.
I guess that was intentional.
No, you...
It was a pile of damp leaves.
You put... It's moving, right? So you put the cross... Oh, George...
The stones were too heavy to turn by hand.
Do I need to turn the stones? I mean, my guess is we need to get up there. Well, I was thinking tie the vines around that, then throw that up there, and then climb up the vine. Obviously not.
It seemed to be working just fine.
Well, that's the point, isn't it? We don't want it working just fine. We want this to open and that ladder to come down. Can you pick up the cross and use it to hook the ladder? No, apparently not. Can't turn the stones by hand. Can you turn them with leverage? Oh, there's little holes in them.
The leverage from the cross allowed me to turn one of the stones, but the other one remained stationary.
Don't know why we're trying to turn these. I'm suddenly confused. Doesn't take much.
The vine provided a drive belt to connect the two stones.
Let's hope it's sturdy enough to take the pressure.
Now I had the contraption working.
Right, okay, but it didn't do anything.
Hello? Anyone home?
It seemed to be working just fine. The iron rim of the water wheel would have torn the skin from my fingers if I touched it.
So that's powering something in there. We can't move that. There's nothing obvious around here. There's nothing new in here, no. There's something in there. Can we tease it out with a worm? No. I guess you just keep spinning the wheels. I'm not sure we have anything to interrupt the water supply. He just turns it once, but that it's not connected to anything.
Two round stones were carefully balanced on a wooden structure.
It's a press for drying things, isn't it? If that's a washing machine. We need someone to come out and kick that ladder down. Thinking, tie it up, cause a problem. And cap it in any way?
It seemed to be working just fine. The machine seemed to be pumping air up to the treehouse. I briefly considered diving into the crystal waters. Very briefly.
So I can't stop the flow of water. What is that? What is it?
It was a pile of damp leaves.
Thanks, George.
It was a pile of damp leaves.
But what happens if you do something with the leaves? That's...
The stones were too heavy to turn by hand.
No, but can you put the dog biscuits on the and then grind them and then... Why do we need to turn this? That's my question. Because he turns it, and then he turns it, but he just does it once. We got anything that we can use as a foothold? Can we pick up the cross to stick in the ground there to give you a foothold?
It would look like a church if I could fasten this cross to it.
That doesn't help.
I couldn't see any great benefit in sharpening the cross.
It's not what I'm thinking.
It seemed to be working just fine.
So I can't carry on up the road. We have to do something here.
It was the flint statue of Tezcatlipoca I'd found in Marseille.
I don't see how any of this is relevant. And why are those leaves moving?
It was a pile of damp leaves. It seemed to be working just fine.
Yeah, I don't really want to hear it seemed to be working just fine again.
There was no way of climbing up to the treehouse.
There is, there's a ladder right there. For some reason, you don't want to put the cross in the ground and jump up, climb. Oh, I'm tired today. I don't know why. So spinning that doesn't do anything. Walk over this way with the cross. Pick up the cross. Oh, okay. So you won't. The cross is stuck there forever now. Not what I wanted.
The contraption consisted of a crude wooden wheel with wooden slats.
And outside of pulling the vine off it, there's nothing that we can do.
The machine was broken.
Like, me personally, if this was me in this situation, I'd be kicking out this to make a scene with these guys, whoever's in here. It seemed to be working just fine. Spins, if we could block that off, but it's not letting me do it. That's pushing air. But there's nothing in here that I can interact with to block the airflow. And the leaves keep moving. That's all just painting. Throw a dog biscuit at the door. The thing that's throwing me is he... When you interact with this, it just... He spins it once, it's obviously not connected to anything. It doesn't do anything. Can we squash the worm in it? What is crushing?
The cone was ideal as a makeshift container.
Right, so that's come out of nowhere. Makeshift container for what? The dog biscuits? The lipstick? That wouldn't do anything. Container for what, George? You wouldn't crush that. Is there already something in it? Is that what I'm missing? No. Okay, so step three.
The cone was ideal as a makeshift container.
Is apparently that. What do we need to press? We can't head out that way, can we? I don't think we have anything.
The machine was broken.
Because it's broken, can we take bits off it to crush? Are you sure that is just damp leaves, Josh?
It was a pile of damp leaves.
Try anything, no matter how stupid. What would we need to crush? Right, I'm doing it. I'm at a stranger's treehouse. What am I to do? Perhaps you can get the attention from whoever. Yes, that's ideally what I want. A fire might attract their attention. A fire? A fire? With what? I haven't got any wood. I can't make a spark. The bank statement in the cone? It's just damp leaves.
Damp leaves. It was a pile of damp leaves.
We haven't got any stones. We haven't got any sticks. Can you scoop up the damp leaves with the chimney cone? It doesn't make sense.
It would have been a shame to tamper with the elegant bridge.
See, he doesn't want to do anything. Even the broken washing machine, he doesn't want to take it apart. George, what are you not understanding? Exactly, so we can burn it.
The contraption consisted of a crude wooden wheel with wooden slats. Not such a good idea. That was no good.
Are you sure?
I don't think so.
Neither do I, but I'm out of ideas
that's
here.
That's wrong.
They might burn.
No, that's wrong.
I'm not understanding. Place the bank statement in the leaves near the... Putting anything in a pile of damp leaves isn't going to light anything. And we don't have any way of lighting it. Right, okay. Place the bank statement in... This makes no sense. This is the first part of this game that doesn't make any sense.
I placed the bank statement over the damp leaves.
Great. Well done. Now we need to make fire. And I'm guessing we need to put something through there to create fire.
The cone was ideal as a makeshift container.
I don't have any stone. Should we have a lighter or something? I mean, you'd think anybody would carry a lighter around with them, right? Even if you don't smoke, you carry a lighter around. You never know when you're going to need fire. It's a pile of damp leaves with a crumpled up bank statement on top.
It was a pile of damp leaves.
I am not getting this. I hate using tips. Use the small statue on the water wheel. That's the first thing that makes sense, but I would never have figured that out. So you're going to put the stone... So what's that all about? That wouldn't burn anyway.
As I held the fetish to the iron rim of the wheel, a shower of sparks cascaded onto the leaves.
I see how that would take the air up there. Reverend?
Quick, man! Put out that fire! I've got a sick woman up here!
Sorry, Father, but I needed to attract your attention.
Why is a priest alone in a treehouse with a sick woman? And why was he not all that concerned by the fire? Does she want dog biscuits?
What do you want?
My name is Stobbart, George Stobbart.
I'm Father Hubert. I don't suppose you speak French.
Huh? Why do you want to know that?
I found a young woman with a fever by the river this morning. The poor girl is close to death.
Nico.
There's nothing I can do for her but pray. I don't understand her, but I think she's speaking French.
Hang on. That must be Nico. That's my girlfriend you've got in your treehouse. What's the matter with her?
She's been bitten by a venomous river snake.
But can't you do something for her? There's a cure, isn't there?
Tequila.
I ran out of penicillin and morphine years ago. But the local people speak of a root which they believe will counteract the poison.
Where can I find this root?
I don't know. But maybe the shaman at the village can tell us.
Okay, where's the shaman?
Can you show me the way to the village?
Me? Oh, but... I can't.
Can't? Nico's life depends on it.
You're right. Of course I should, despite my own guilt and shame.
I don't care about your guilt and shame.
I can't go as a representative of God with a creased collar.
A creased collar? You mean you put your personal attire higher than the life of a sick woman?
I will not go to that village looking anything but my best.
Give me your collar. I'm sure I can find a way to press it.
Fucking... My son. Religious
in the meantime,
bollocks.
I must contemplate my sermon.
I don't...
There was obviously more than a creased collar bothering the priest.
This bit we've already worked out.
So there I was, hundreds of miles from civilization, doing the housework for a priest. It's a strange world.
It's a very strange world.
The press worked surprisingly well on the collar.
Of course it did, it's a press. Right, she's been bitten by a poisonous snake. I've pressed your collar. Can we go to the village, Hubert?
Here's your collar, Father.
I thought they were made of plastic, anyway.
Thank you, George. You probably think it a little odd of me to make such a fuss.
Oh, no. If I'd been living in the jungle for 11 years, I'd be completely screwy, too.
Screwy? Yes, perhaps I am. Ever since my last visit to that village.
Can we go now?
Do you want to tell me what happened at the village?
I forgot my vows. I let myself be overwhelmed by the beauty of this unspoiled paradise.
You took a wife.
In a moment of weakness, animal passion reared its rampant head.
Okay, you know, he'd slept with someone.
You should be writing romantic novels. Did you experience some kind of a physical liaison at the village?
Yes, I'm ashamed to admit it, but I found myself doing the monkey dance.
You were doing a what with a what now?
I've never heard it called that before. And I didn't want to pry any deeper into Hubert's murky past.
I think we all know what these religious types are like.
Now you've got your collar back, will you take me to the village?
I've still not finished my sermon. Look,
I don't give a fuck.
I still don't know why you're so reluctant to visit that village. And it's none of my business. Whatever the reason, it can't be more important than saving Nico's life.
You're right. I must be crazy. We must make haste if we're to reach the village before nightfall.
How far away are we?
By the time we reached the village, it was sunset.
Hello, boys. Glad to see you're still wearing the underpants.
They're the best Christmas present we ever had, Father.
Well, they speak exceptionally well.
Well, we all have our cross to bear. This is George. He has a request to make. I'm afraid I can't stay. Good luck, George.
Thanks, Father.
That's a relief. I never feel comfortable with him about.
Me neither. These damn pants keep riding right up my butt.
So, what do you want?
This is insane. This is even weirder than what we had to do with the damp leaves.
My girlfriend has been bitten by a snake.
So? Everyone in my family has been bitten by snakes.
I was bitten by a dormouse once.
She's real sick. I hoped your wise man might have medicine.
Wise man? You must have the wrong village.
Father Hubert said there was a wise man in the village who could help me.
Ooh, he must mean the old man, the shaman.
Yeah, that guy.
I'd like to see the shaman, please.
You can't just go walking in there and demand to speak to the shaman.
Why not?
You have to observe the protocol. The shaman demands tribute.
Tribute? You mean like a gift?
That's right.
The eternal question. What do you give a man who has everything?
Lipstick.
Would your wise man have any use for lipstick?
Not in that color.
Haven't you anything in black?
Of course I don't.
Dog biscuits?
Here, he'll like these biscuits.
If you say so.
Can we get rid of the biscuits? He liked them?
He liked the biscuits, especially the black ones. He wants to know if you've any more.
No, but I do have a worm.
Look, I know it's not much, but I want your shaman to have this.
Do you expect him to eat that?
He's an old man, you know. He might choke.
Oh, it didn't do it.
I didn't think the Indians would accept that gift.
I don't think they're Indians, George. I wasn't going to address this until my final thoughts, but the terminology in this game is obviously old-fashioned. It was made in 1996/1997. So, forgive the slights and the wrong terminology. It is a little bit of its time. What about this?
I didn't think the Indians would accept that gift.
Well, they're not going to accept anything, are they?
There wasn't much point in sending the empty box back to the shaman.
I don't want to show him that. I don't...
This stone is what brought me here.
That's a spirit stone. I wouldn't touch it if I was you.
You're right. It could be cursed.
Do you want to poison dart?
I didn't think the Indians would accept that gift.
What about paper?
I didn't think the Indians would accept that gift.
Well, I don't have any more biscuits.
There wasn't much point in sending the empty box back to the shaman.
Give me a clue. What kind of things does your shaman like? Does he have a hobby, a favorite sport?
You insult us. The shaman lives on a higher plane.
Oh, right. Maybe a book would be more suitable. Or a jigsaw puzzle?
Don't you just hate choosing presents for people you don't know?
Are you going to stand by and let my girlfriend die?
Of course not. What do you think we are, savages?
We'll start the preparations for a cremation feast.
Great. I can't even leave. I haven't got any gifts.
There wasn't much point in sending the empty box back to the shaman.
I can't just walk in. I honestly can't leave.
Stop! This is a private village.
I got nothing for you, pal. Do you want these? No.
I didn't think the Indians would accept that gift.
But you could try anyway. Can I stick him with it? Look, my friend.
There wasn't much...
excuse me. Right, George.
You can't go in there.
Do you want these? Oh, he just goes back to that one.
I didn't think the Indians would accept that gift.
So he doesn't want a worm, he doesn't want lipstick. I have no more dog biscuits because we threw so many at the dog. I am not seeing anything that I can interact with here. I don't think I can leave. So you can send him a gift in disguise. He won't put that on himself.
No, I had to think of something else. I wasn't convinced that was the right thing to do.
What would be a gift in disguise? Worm in the... No! No!
I dropped the tequila worm into the empty box.
No!
Here, I found some more of those biscuits for the shaman.
I don't like this idea. And it's just one worm at the bottom of the box. That will get him very drunk.
He
He didn't want the little worm. He's a vegetarian.
I put the Mayan stone in the empty box.
Here, I found some more of those biscuits for the shaman.
These people are idiots.
I'll give them to him.
So it's either that or it's the little feta. It's that.
The shaman wants to talk to you.
I hoped he would. Well, it's been nice to talk to you guys.
Right, brain, engage. We were doing so well until we started this. Not that I can see her.
That woman certainly wasn't the reason I'd come to the village.
Look at them running around naked in the background.
That man wasn't the one I'd come looking for.
Hi, my name's George Stobbart.
Please, sit down. Welcome, George.
Thanks.
It has long been foretold that a white man would bring the Coyote Stone to this village.
Really?
Why is Father Hubert so reluctant to visit the village?
I don't know. He used to come here a lot, but then he just stopped. You'd think he'd want to spend some time with his kids.
Did you say Father Hubert has kids?
3 girls and 5 boys by my
reckoning. Oh, God.
All conceived in the same week at the Feast of the Monkey Dance.
The Monkey Dance?
I don't suppose this would be any use to you.
It sure would. This wax on a stick will change our lives.
What do you want it for?
To decorate our bodies for the monkey dance.
Here you go.
My girlfriend's been bitten by a snake.
And you want me to heal her?
That's the idea. Can you do it?
I'm not sure. My gums aren't what they used to be.
Listen, my girlfriend's in a coma.
Please, we don't know
old
that.
Man, give me the root.
What root?
Father Hubert told me of a root which could cure the bite of the river snake.
There's nothing sacred with these people. That was our secret, known only to members of my tribe.
If that root is my chance of saving Nico's life, then I want it. Fast.
There is time yet, George Stobbart. Time to learn why you were called here.
Are we going to get a tale of prophecy?
Fine. If I listen to your story, then will you give me the root?
The eel travels far, but still returns to the place of his spawning.
And look, I'm running a tight schedule, so can you skip the riddles?
Many years ago, when the world was young, the great god and king Quetzalcoatl was defeated by trickery and deceit.
I've heard of Quetzalcoatl.
His enemy, Tezcatlipoca, took his place as leader and demanded terrible human sacrifices. A group of loyal priests found a way to trap Tezcatlipoca. But his powers were so great, they knew he would not remain trapped forever.
The smoking mirror.
Incarceration would end with the eclipse, which marked the close of the fifth age. So the priests fashioned 3 obsidian stones which contained the power to seal the mirror for all time. But before the stones could be put in place, they were seized by the invading Spanish.
That was
how
cool.
How did they trap Tez, the evil god?
They built a pyramid which they told Tezcatlipoca was dedicated to him. At its center, they fashioned a huge mirror of perfectly smooth obsidian. Luring him into the pyramid with praise and flattery, they used sorcery to ensnare him in the mirror.
Suppose I was to believe there was anything in your story, other than the rambling delusions of a seriously wacky old man.
We still need that root.
Suppose I was to swallow it, hook, line, and kitchen sink.
What then?
Then you would see that the fate of the human race rests upon your shoulders.
What happened to the stones?
They were taken by the Spanish to the coastal town that is now called Quaramonte City. Only one stone reached Spain. The other two fell into the hands of buccaneers. The Jaguar stone was captured by an English captain, El Draco. The Eagle stone
English.
Was taken by a pirate called Ketch. The third stone, the Coyote stone, reached Spain safely. That is the stone in your possession.
Tell me more about the Eagle stone.
The stone was loaded onto a galleon with many valuable artifacts plundered by the Spanish. But shortly after leaving harbor, a terrible squall blew up and damaged the ship. The ship was intercepted by a bloodthirsty pirate, Captain Ketch. Ketch made short work of overpowering the crew, stealing the treasure, and sinking the Spanish ship.
Where's the Eagle Stone now?
Nobody knows for sure. Ketch retired from piracy and bought an island in the Caribbean.
Tell me more about the Jaguar.
We have 9 days.
Many centuries ago, the port of Quaramonte was entered by a ship flying Spanish colors. The captain, the man known as El Draco, sent soldiers ashore. Only when the soldiers arrested the mayor did the people realize that they were English privateers. The mayor was held hostage while the soldiers looted and plundered the city. Amongst the treasures they stole was the Jaguar Stone.
Where is the Jaguar Stone now?
I suppose El Draco took it back to his homeland, across the Great Sea.
To England? What do I do when I find the stones?
Bring them here to me and I shall prepare you. The stones must be taken to the heart of the pyramid. Only there can they be used to seal the gate by which Tezcatlipoca will return to this world.
It would take more than 9 days to go to these places.
Do I get anything to help me combat Tezcatlipoca?
Like what?
Well, a magical weapon?
Get real, George.
Can you show me the way to the pyramid of Tezcatlipoca?
Not until you possess all 3 stones.
There's an eclipse of the sun due very soon, isn't there?
Correct. The eclipse which marks the ending of the Fifth Age will come before the next full moon.
Less than 2 weeks. I didn't really believe that Tezcatlipoca would return, but I figured Karzak's plans were in some way connected.
Yeah.
Now do I get the route?
Here. Take it. Make haste if you wish to save the girl's life. The hummingbird sings to me of death to come.
Now you're talking in riddles again. Listen, is it okay if I crash here?
No, you've got to go back.
I've got no chance of finding my way through the jungle in the dark.
You're welcome, but you probably won't get much sleep. Tonight's the night of the monkey dance.
Great. Great. Well done, George. You time everything perfectly. Has he got a spring in his step?
I left the village at dawn and stumbled back through the jungle in a post-party daze. It was just like sneaking back to my parents' house when I was younger. Except Oakland didn't have monkeys or parrots.
Right, let's do this then. Finally work out what this is for. I'm trying to save time here, because we have wasted an entire evening and probably most of the morning.
As the liquid was squeezed from the root, it collected in the cone.
Hey! The one thing I thought was going to get us up there is actually worthwhile. Don't spill it. It is Nico. I think we sort of knew that.
The antidote. Well, what are you waiting for? Give it to the girl, quickly.
He's useless. I already don't like him.
Nico. Here, drink this.
Oh, George, it's horrible.
Just swallow it down. Okay, try and rest now, darling. You'll need all your strength when we go after the other 2 stones.
Other stones? What other stones? What have you gotten me into now, George Stobbart?
Well, the patient is sounding more like her old self already.
Great. After flying across the Caribbean Sea.
Nico recovered quickly from her fever.
Of course she did. She's pissed off at George.
We decided to split up and look for each stone independently. I traced the pirate catch to a remote island in the Caribbean with the fortune he'd amassed from piracy. He'd retired to a place that was later called Ketch's Landing.
Makes sense. Are they filming something here? Nico survived, thank God. She was rescued by a priest, Father Hubert, who found her on the riverbank. The guy was preoccupied with playing his organ music, and I had to work overtime to convince him to take me to a village where I hoped to find a route that could save Nico's life. I had to persuade the local guards to let me see their shaman. Initially, they were reticent, but after some Stobbart charm and a little deception, he invited me in and we talked. According to Mayan legend, the great god Quetzalcoatl was defeated by the evil god Tezcatlipoca, who demanded human sacrifices. The coyote stone we found was one of three stones created to imprison Tezcatlipoca for all eternity, the others being the eagle stone and a jaguar stone, or jaguar stone. Unfortunately, before they could put it in place, it was seized up by invading Spanish and later split up. The eagle stone was captured by a pirate named Ketch, the jaguar stone by an English sea captain called El Draco, and the coyote stone reached Spain safely. The shaman gave me the route to cure Nico, and once she was well enough, we decided to split up. One of the leads from the shaman pointed to an island called Ketch's Landing in the Caribbean, so I went there to hunt down the eagle stone, while Nico sent to London in search of the jaguar stone. Yeah, Nico's got... It's probably best that she went to London, because George would lose focus and she's got the bigger task.
Hello.